Sir, just the other night we were talking to Sergio Ortiz Luis ng ECOP and he was warning us na ano na na maraming mga restaurant owners daw malamang ay kahit may 10% 30% na papayagan indoors and outdoors eh maraming pa rin daw hindi magbubukas dahil I suppose parang ano eh parang economies of scale eh. Not enough people, baka not worth opening. I don't know, ano po yung numbers niyo from what you could see? Ilan po yung nagbukas versus what you expected?
It's very difficult to look for data right now. It's only been 2 days, but also because restaurant is a very diverse industry. We also cover karinderia as part of our industry. Mm. So you're right. There are certain restaurateurs who would rather not open at 10% capacity because it's sometimes also painful to open at 10%.
Yeah.
But for a large part of our membership, 10% is already better than zero. And for myself personally, I would rather open with 10% and hire a few people, give them some paycheck so they can start having a life again. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, they're just waiting for help, or they're doing sidelines. They're part-timing as GP drivers or delivery drivers, and sometimes that's a very risky situation for them. So getting them back into the restaurant where they're protected in some ways, it's much better.
Yeah.
But are you doing simultaneous, delivery system and at the same time actual face-to-face service? Is that what it's come to? Parang sinasabay niyo na lang yung negosyo to maximize?
Delivery, for example, in our business is probably around 10%, 12% of total sales, which is quite small. And sometimes it's really not worth doing because the amount you pay for delivery services is quite high, 20%+ of sales. So, but sometimes that's a necessity when you don't have dine-in. But now that we have dine-in customers, it doesn't hurt to have delivery. It doesn't hurt to have takeaway. We try to get as much sales as we can because every test counts right now, every minute, every day that we can stay in business. That's really vital. We're hoping lang that we can carry over from a bad third quarter to a healthier fourth quarter, hopefully. Mm-hmm. It's just a matter of days.
So among your members, Mr. Teng, kumusta naman tong the first 2 days of the shift to, well, easing of restrictions on your sector, no? Kumusta naman po yung foot traffic for dine-in?
It's better than I expected, to be honest. I wasn't expecting much because I felt people are still wary of going out, but we were surprised yesterday. It wasn't, tremendous fiesta kind of atmosphere, but it was healthier than expected. And today was also a good day, but it's never a dangerous situation. It's never a crowded situation where people are lining up or crowding up just to get into a restaurant. No, that's not the case at all. But I'm seeing a healthier perspective of our consumers. Once they're vaccinated, they're willing to go about, but then they still practice, the safety protocols, mass distancing, and hand washing. So, and also in the restaurant business, we're used to that even before COVID.
But do you find yourself having to turn away customers because you stand a chance of exceeding your 10% indoors and 30%
and
outdoors?
And how difficult
I just wonder.
We do. Actually, yesterday, surprisingly, a lot of people wanted to go in without bringing their vaccination card. So regretfully, we had to turn them away. But for many restaurants, we just ask them to order takeout. So that's one good business opportunity. In another restaurant, our practice would be if it's full already, because frankly, there are sometimes just 3 or 4 tables and it's already considered a full house because that's 10%. Then we'd get their phone number and they go about first and ask them to come back at a certain time and the table will be free for them. We try to accommodate our customers as well as we can. And we try to make the best of the current situation. There are also instances where customers, of course, restaurants, you have a blended group. Some will be vaccinated, some won't be vaccinated. So when you have a group where a party has some unvaccinated people and we don't have outdoor dining, that's when we also regretfully would have to turn them away. It's a good thing when restaurants have options of both indoor and outdoor dining, then they can accommodate both. But for malls, restaurants, usually it's interior located restaurants.